Many representatives of mass media say that this social institution merely reflects the society and culture in which it exists. People in the mass media business, like disc jockeys and program managers, have an important influence on the culture.
DJs can do the most to promote a record mainly because they become friends with the listener on the radio. And when they say good things about a song, it's much the same as if a friend of yours would be telling you about a particular song that they like and think that you might also enjoy. And in that regard, that probably does the most for playing a record that anything can do, because it, again, is just a personal thing. The listener relates to the person on the radio as a friend. It's a personal thing from them to the listener. They like the song. Here's something you might enjoy as well. You can't get much better than that. You can hear a song 100 times, but if somebody says, hey, this is a good song, I think you ought to hear it too, it seems to make more sense to the listener. We have a lot of different sources of input for why we choose a record. We look at trade magazines such as Billboard Magazine, Radio and Records, and several others. We cull information from the charts, which tell us that these are the most popular songs in the country right now. These are the new songs that will be hot in the next month or so. We'll look at those things, and we'll listen to everything. And as it comes in, we'll judge it on just the merit of the song itself, plus the reaction that it's having across the country, how other stations' airplay is affecting the movement of the song up the charts. And if it fits in with what we're doing overall, then we also, you know, feel that this is something we could play. We look for songs that are going to appeal to our target demographic, which is adults 25 to 54, mainly female. Anything, obviously, that's going to be an irritant to someone like that is not something we would consider. Extraterrestrials listening to the radio would learn about Americans, probably that we think a whole lot about romance. There's a great decoupling of America and reuniting of couples as well. They would probably think that everyone in America is on an endless search for love. It's something that we can never have enough of. And if we have it, we don't know that we have what we want. We're always looking for a better mate or a better situation. Romance takes up probably 90% of the music that we play. They would also realize fairly quickly that we are a reminiscent society. We think back a lot to good times from the past and spend a great deal of our time with our memories.